Nein, 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 אתה לא ראית את זה. נאי 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 Na 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 לעילוי נשמעסי ממרוסי רוס בס מורדכי. This guy's from Baltimore, I'm telling you. Lemaisa, it's a tremendous, tremendous night. We have guests from all over. But I want to point out the guests from America. We have official Gross right over here. And they came in special for the Siyum, I believe. We have Rabbi Yossi Klein, who for sure came into the Siyum. Wie ze heißt der Rabbi Yossi? Dovi? Glauber. Glauber? What's your name?
Glauber.
Dovi Glauber. Also, Glauber, Glauber. And then you have Yedid. Wie ze heißt der? Yedid Leibovitz, right? But how? Yedi. Yedi, Yedi. Yidi Leibovitz, also from Monsir HaKodesh. Who else do we have here? From Chutz La'aretz. Anybody from Chutz La'aretz? No, no, he lives here. Oh, where? Schleifer from Baltimore. Shalom Aleichem. Oh, you gave me this thing, right? That's you? Shkoya. Look at this. What time now? We got it. How do you take this out? You don't take it out. It's for show, but it's an MDY battle. Oh, sorry. This is never gonna. I'm never gonna open this Belina Adir. I said that about the other ones, but then my son got to it somehow. This is Daf Yomi. American, put it on the side. What else do we have? Huh? Okay. So we have here. I didn't. Oh. Here we go. Yeah, pass it around. Why not? Don't break it. We have here five guys from South Africa, from Cape Town, who are making a siyum. On Rosh Hashanah, Amir Gelgor, Sasha Katz, Liad Gelgor, Sam Goransky, and Rabbi Avi Shlomo. Here they are. So mazel tov to them. You know any of these guys? The Cape Town. You're not from Cape Town. Right by the table, right, this is the table mountain, right over here. Beautiful. We have here an email from Chabatsker, Lubavitcher, whatever you want to call it. Good day, MDY family. Before I start my email, I'd like to thank my dear cousin, the MDY recruiter of the family, Mr. Shlomi Klein. I love you and thank you for letting me know about Rebelli's class. It's been almost 20 years since I finished the Masechta, and the Masechta Motzi Shabbos, I'll be finishing Rosh Hashanah with the MDY family. Baruch Hashem, I learned the early AM, my daily chitas and Rambam with Rabbi Josh Gordon on Chabad.org. May I have an Aliyah's Neshama. Bekitzer, he's saying that Rabbi Josh has a chush to really connect with the students in a way like no other, and I didn't find anyone in my life like him that teaches that way, and I'm near 40 years old. That was until... I heard of you, which really reminded me of the way Rabbi Josh teaches. I have to say it. It's a bracha from Hashem. Da, 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 da. I started your shir with Rosh Hashanah, and I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for giving me the schuss to learn with you. Thank you, Shloimeh, for bringing me on board. I look forward to be your student for many, many years to come. Atzlocha. Good Shabbos and Mazel Tov in the scene of Rosh Hashanah. Yankee Brook. Here he is. Well, not really. He's hiding behind the picture of the Rebbe somewhere. Shkoya.
London or life?
Huh?
London or life?
I didn't hear what he said, but okay. Oh, London is live on Zoom. They have 65 people in London by the Seum. Rabbi, it's unbelievable. There's over 500 people registered for Seumim, MDY Seumim around the world. Signed up, registered. That's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. Levi Ginsberg, hi, I'm reaching out to my extended family, NDY. First of all, to thank you, Rebelli, and the family for the shin environment you create. I had my first baby boy a week ago, and he really needs a refuah shlema. He's on seizure medication and a ventilator. He tried to donate gemaras, for some reason it didn't go through. A lot of people are complaining about that. His name is Tinoik Ben Sara. If the family can please daven for his quick recovery. Thanks again for everything you do, and please let me know if you got this email. Kol Tov, and Mesuras Toivas. We can just keep on going until the sponge is done over there. What else do we have here? This one we'll read a different time, maybe. This one is anonymous, so please don't read my name like you did the last time you read my unsigned letter. I think Dailam knows who it is already, no? Hey, why am I back? I got hooked into Yashir and first 2 days in the dive and finally joined the full show. Yashir's incredible, fun jokes, prowess, banter. My daughter, seminary teacher, Rabbi Nachman Seltzer, the most of all the clear explanations make Yashir one of a kind. I especially appreciate how when you're about to encounter a confusing or detailed piece, you stop and explain before we sit inside rather than just say it, explain it, we just help someone. Rebelli, because of you, for the first time my learning is smooth as a baby's cheek. When Yitzchak became old, seriously, for the first time in a long time, I don't dread learning. I look forward to it. And now I look forward to making a scene this Shabbos, Bezer Hashem, and my wife could not be happier, Baruch Hashem. Thanks for the opportunity to join a family, Lemdei, Machzik, Torah, the Gishmak MDY family. Short one, maybe. This one we said already. This is from Albert Satin. Me and my son really enjoy the shir. Carpool has never been so much fun. Is there a way to get a video right after his tape? I know the editing takes time, but maybe the unedited version can be uploaded for those who can't wait. If you are subscribed on YouTube and you go into your, what is it?
Subscriptions.
Not our channel. If you're on, you go to your subscriptions on YouTube, so you can see the shir even before it's uploaded. That's what they say. You learn new things every day before it's edited. And here's another guy that says that you don't really need install a floating YouTube app. And you can have a mini YouTube window playing in the corner of the screen. I use Vanced. You should call for your wonderful Twitter project. Shapsi Cohen, Beitar. They do it. That's you? Oh, you wrote this. Yishkoyah. For some reason, did you write that app? No. You just download. Okay. All right, Rabbi Isai, here we go. Ask as many questions as you want tonight because the longer it takes, the better for us. Also, just as a side note, we're all going to come together. It's right next door. And I got it. Right next door. So please let these guys at the door, please don't bud and try. I'm here in the shir. I'm here for 6 years already. I'm best friends with Ellie. Da, da, da. Just stand in line nicely. We'll all get in. I'll also wait in line, Bezer Hashem. It'll take a few minutes, but we'll get. I did not pay. But Noam Fick said he'll cut. Give me some slack. Rabbi said tonight is a very special night because we are 25% into Shas. We're starting the 26% right now. What are you showing me over there? From Mati? It better be good. Well, I have no idea what you're saying. Okay, thank you, Mati. I have no idea. What? What? For the amount of people that don't worry. Shmuel Yecht, F245 in honor of the Afyami community, not solo members who push up versus the Torah. Linish Madiv Chaver, Mordechai Shalom, Pinchas Tuvi, Allah Shalom, whenever Moshe Peretz, New York Kopman. The Sechel of Shoshana is dedicated, and this is the last day, by Yossi and Esti Elbaum and their children, Tehila and Ruvain. Lizech and Nishmas, their mother and grandmother, Bela Woman, Bela Tzipar Basri, Ruvain. Tehila Sarah Bas Esther, Leah for a Shidduch. We should hear Psurus Torah soon. The Paras Achoydesh, Kislev, is sponsored by Yoili. Lilinish was Dov Pinchas Ben Moshe, Lilinish was Chomachayr from Dov Pinchas, and Lilinish was Zechiel Shragim and Avram Alevi. Or if it takes too much time, just say, Lilinish is his father, sister, and Shver. Paras Achoydesh, Reuven Klein, my mother, Nechama Bas Kolev, Elio Chaya Frischman, in honor of Mr. Farkovitz, and Aaron Zelig for inspiring Yosef Frischman, 13 years old, to join the Daf. Beautiful. Shol Wasserthiel, Tzipar Bas Moshe Benachem Alevi, Edno. Oh, sorry. No, it goes something like this. It's written backwards. Lili Nishmas. Eko Edno Tzipora Bas Moshe Menachem Alevi. Okay, that's how you have to read it. Nilva Ates Tamos Tovshin Peyal. Tonight, cheers dedicated to our dear son David. We have reason to believe is making a scene tonight on learning Sechus Roshana with Rebellion while in Shana Rishayna. Wow. Shana Rishayna. And of course, Jay Spector, who got me. What are you laughing? What's so fan? Rosh Hashanah and Shana Rishayna. And of course, Jay Spector, who got me into Rebellion. You know the guy, right? You know this guy? Pressman. David Pressman, you know? He dives in your shul, no? He dives in the other one. And of course, Jay Spector got me into Rebellion in the beginning of Bracha, Zalchan Pressman, Umishpachtik. Bel Rosenberg, Lefor Shlema, for Liran, Bracha, Bashen, Lulea. Uri Tov, Lina Nishma, my father, Lezal Liban, Ben Ramosha, Arya, Levi, Zarzav is today, Tes Kislev. Meir Tesser, Rabbi Isai, I see you're a little antsy. We're starting in a minute. Meir Tesser, in honor of Eli Sendarovich, L83, for pushing me to join, and Baruch Hashem making scene for the first time in many years. Rabbi Isai, in the last and final one, by Eli Dykman, Lekuvid, L-E-K-U-V-I-D, Lekuvid, my 11-year-old son, Avrumi, finishing his first Masechta, 11-year-old finishing his first Masechta. Thank you, Rebellion. Maybe a source of nachas for us and the whole MDY family. Way to go, Eli Dykman. All right, here we go. We're holding, I don't know how many lines. 15 lines. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 lines from the top. Tonarabonon. Tekiois ein ma'akvois zuazu. Brachois ein ma'akvois zuazu. So the way Rashi learns, others learn differently, the way it's, you would think it is. But the way Rashi learns is that on a tainus, other than Rosh Hashanah, when you have the blowing of the shofar and the bracha is different additions to Shmoneh Esrei, one, if you do the shofar without the brachas without the shofar, they're not ma'akev. We're not talking about the shofar, ma'akev itself. We're not talking about the brachas. If you say five out of the six, you're not going to know. If you say the brachas, you say the Shmoneh Esrei, whatever you have to say on a fast day, in those days when it didn't rain, it was the end of the world. They used to fast all the time. Sometimes in Israel, they fast as well today. If you say the brachas in Shmoneh Esrei and you don't blow the shofar, not the end of the world. However, the tkiyos of Rosh Hashanah are ma'akev. In other words, if you don't say Malchuyos, Zuchroinus, and Shofrois, and you heard the Shofar, no good. You can't just come and blow the Shofar and not say the Shmoneh Esrei and Musaf. You can't say Shmoneh Esrei and Musaf without hearing the Shofar. One of them, they're both connected to each other. I saw once a video, very interesting video. I believe it's a real one. It makes a lot of sense. In New York, you know, like when they have potholes, it takes like 25 years to fix. If you ever lived in New York, you know what I'm talking about. There's a video, famous one, of a guy on a truck, and it says, you know, Department of Transportation on the truck, and he has a shovel in his hand, and he's taking dirt from the truck and pouring it onto the street. Then there's another Chochem Batata on the ground, takes a shovel of dirt and throws it into the truck. And this is how they're going for 5 minutes. He's throwing it off, he's putting it on, and that's what they're getting paid. The union pays them. But this is actually part of a real mashal. That's it's a real video. Look it up. I couldn't find it, but it's there. Ayin Shom. But don't Ayin Shom, he says. But there's Shom Aleichem. What's your name?
Yair Shvat.
Yair Shvat Shom Aleichem. Efa ata?
Elazar.
Oh, you brought him. Shkoyach. Very nice. So, not Efrat, right across the street. So, why were they doing that? And the answer is because, typically speaking, you have three people. You have a guy that digs a hole. The second guy comes, plants a tree, and the third guy covers it. Well, the middle guy didn't show up that day. So they just continue working. Each guy did his job. He dug, the other guy gets this. This is what we're talking about over here. You have to do the full thing. If you just do Shmoneh Esrei, then you don't even have a Shmoneh Esrei. It's like taking dirt off a truck and putting it back on the truck. You have to do the whole thing. In order to be Yoytzeh, you have to do Shmoneh Esrei, and you have to do Tkiyas. If you just do Rosh Hashanah, you just do Shmoneh Esrei, it's taking off the, you just do the blowing of the Shmoneh. Yeah, it's a whole, the certain parts that you must do in order to be Yoytzeh the mitzvah. Says Gemara. My time. Omer Rabbah, Omer HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Imru lefonai Rosh Hashanah Malchuyah Zichronis V'Shoifers. I want you to say these three things. You have to mention that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the king of the world. Zichronis, the remembrance in front of him, and Shoifers. Malchuyah is Kadesh Tamluchuni Aleichem. That you make me your king. Zichronis Kadesh Yovai lefonai Zichronichem L'Toiva. I need that everybody should come out okay. But with what instrument? B'shoifar. Misha berach v'achakach nesman alei shoifar. Person, daven shmoneh esrei, and only afterwards he got a shoifar, tekeya, maria v'tekeya, he does the regular shoifar. Taimo, delay have alei shoifar mikara. Why do you do it after Musaf? Because he didn't have a shoifar. Have alei shoifar mikara. Listen to this. Nusach Svard is going to love this. If you have a shofar to begin with, kisham alohu, aseide brachoy sham alohu. Seems like from the Gemara right here that the best way to do it is within Shmoneh Esrei. As you're davening Shmoneh Esrei, the svardim, nusach svard, blow the shofar with the brachas. Kisham alohu, aseide brachoy sham alohu. Within Chazor Shashat, they say that Reb Pinchas Scheinberg, who is Nusach Ashkenaz, he wanted to be Yoytzeh this Gemara. So he davened an extremely long Shmoneh Esrei that when they blew the shofar in Chazor Shashas Mutzev, he would be at that bracha during his Shtil Shmoneh Esrei. Rapapa bar Shmuel kom letzaluyeh. Rapapa, the son of Shmuel, he came to daven the Shtil Shmoneh Esrei, the quiet Shmoneh Esrei. Omalei l'shamei, kinahir nalach. I'm going to signal to you, I'll lift up my finger or something. Talk Ali, some are goyres with a ches, nechirno, if they go, give a little snort, then you'll know that I'm at the bracha, go ahead. He snorts, and he goes, it was like an interesting, you're standing on the side, it's kind of interesting. Now, this is in private, this is in his house somewhere. This whole idea of blowing the shofar, middle Shmoneh Esrei, even through somebody else, is when you have a tzibur, when you have a whole community, not you and your private shamish blowing your shofar in your home. You hear it in a certain seder with tkiyah, trua, tkiyah. It has to be, you can't just do trua tkiya tkiya. It has to be al seder. Tkiya, trua tkiya. The other day we said, okay, so we add things because of the suffix, the tkiya, shvarim, trua tkiya, whatever it is, but it has to be on a seder. Al seder brachas. And it should be in a very specific way. When we get to malchuyos, you blow. When you get to zechronis, you blow. Bemedvar mamurim bechever ir. Avashaloi bechever ir, shoymin al seder, veloi, vishaloi al seder brachas. That's all when you're in a minyan. But you're not with a minyan, then you hear it, al seder v'shalei al seder brachos. You have to blow it in a certain order, like we do, you're blowing for for your wife, you'll blow it in a certain order, but not together with the Shmoneh Esrei. The Yachid Sheloi Taka, Chavir Takeh Eloi. Here's a halacha that you could be yaitza from your friend. Your friend can blow a shofar for you. V'yachet shalei beirach. But your friend who didn't damage Shmoneh Esrei, eichaveirim mevarech olav. I cannot be yaitza you for Shmoneh Esrei. So we'll see that halacha in a second. U'mitzvah ba'atoikin yoisim ha'amim mevarechim. It's better to blow shofar than to damage Shmoneh Esrei. Keitza, what does that mean? Shtei ayarois. You have two cities. Machas toikin ha'machas mevarechim. One city, they're going to blow the shofar. The other city, they're going to daven Shmoneh Esrei. I have a sort of a picture here. Why not? You go this way, you go that way. Which way do you go? One, there's a shofar blowing. What shofar of Oisai? The Rabban and the Raisa? Very good. Shmoneh Esrei, the Rabban and the Raisa? Most Rishayim hold. Is the Rabbanan. The Rabbim holds the Rai, so it seems like from over here, that is the Rabbanan. You ask about it. Okay.
Is it not contradiction to what you just said before?
I meant everybody else could ask questions, not you. I'm just going, okay, chas v'shalom, go ahead. No.
Is it not contradiction what you said just before, that Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yimol Lefanai?
Yeah. The what?
Just
not good questions.
What?
Not good questions.
Okay.
You stumped me. It's going to be mamish embarrassing. No, go. What? What did we say before?
That's
it. Yeah?
That's
it.
So it's mashma that it's the
Ah, yeah, okay. Right. They bring, so the Ramban doesn't know this, the Rambam doesn't know this Gemara, so he says, yeah. I'm saying the whole Gemara is not. Oh, you're talking about
that the Gemara comes to this.
Oh, you're talking about the Raisa, okay. I hear different things, different. Is it a, might be a smach that they say, maybe this, that, I hear. Pshita, hoder Raisa, hoder Rabbanon, where's the Mefurish, when Esther's the Rabbanon? So the Rambam has what to answer. What's going on is that you're not sure if you're going to make it for shofar blowing. You forgot when they announced. So it's going to be at 10 o'clock, 10:15. You might miss it, but you might make it. Over here, you know for a fact you're going to make a Victor Folders in the house all the way from up north. Over here, you're going to get it. You're going to daven Shmoneh Esrei. So what do you do? Safek Doiraisa overcomes a Vaday Durabanon. As I said, what?
Looks like you're out of the
4,000 feet you got. This looks like more than 4,000 feet to you. Come on. Okay, Kashafa picture. Now, some say that a bracha main shalosh, when you say a bracha achrayna on wine is a deraisa. It's such a shita. So if that's true, so it comes out that if you have a suffix bracha, if you forgot if you made a bracha achrayna on wine, so to make another bracha, suffix bracha levatala is the rabbanon. So the deraisa trumps the rabbanon. You'd have to say another bracha achrayna because that's a deraisa. And to make a bracha levatala is the rabbanon. That's what I saw somewhere. Okay, weiter. Next. If the shliach tzibur, the chazan, could be made to you, why in the world would you daven? It would be pretty cool. Come to shul, you go straight to chazar shashat. You don't have to do anything, just wait, you stand. And you have to listen to every word, but somebody can do it for you. Interesting. Only to give a chance to the chazan to figure out what's going on. Don't forget that in those days, they didn't have sidurim. And you see from Gemara Brachas, people used to make up their own stuff and stick in their own. You have to prepare. It's hard, it's tough stuff. It's all about peh. So to give you the chance. I saw somewhere, forgot where, a few days ago actually I saw this, that very interesting, it's going to really bother Nusach Sfard, not as much as Nusach Ashkenaz. Nusach Sfard, you ever notice, I'm telling you, Nusach Sfard guys, they're kind of anti-Ashkenaz. Ashkenaz, not so much. You go into Nusach Sfarad Shul, you'll never find the Nusach Ashkenaz Siddur. It doesn't, no. Chas and Shalom. I don't want to be Lifnei Iver to give the guy Ashkenaz. But your grandfather Davin Ashkenaz. Ah, he's a Meshigan. He didn't know about the, okay, fine. If you're a chazan, let's say he comes, Nebuch, Chas v'Shalom, Lo Yitzur Yidav Nusach Sfar, and you come to Ashkenaz Shul. And you're going to daven. You're going to be a mensch. You're going to daven Ashkenaz with everybody. You're going to be the Shlich Tzvi with Ashkenaz. What Nusach do you daven when you're in the quiet Shemina Esrei? Ashkenaz is Sfar. Now you, most of the time you'd say, what's the difference? Sfar, of course, Sfar. What, I'm going to be Nichshal twice in one day? So you daven to yourself Ashkenaz. But from here you see that the whole point of Tfilas Lachash is to be Mesadir your Tfilah. Azoy Zakman. So it goes both ways. If you daven Ashkenaz in your Sfar Shul, you have to prepare Nusach Sfar. They have a lot of funny words in Nusach Sfar. Ashkenaz is probably simpler. But not Yatzmach. I'm talking about Shemini Esrei now. Yatzmach. Don't be Yatzmach. The guys, I'm not kidding. Did I tell you the story? In the Koilo last week, we daven Nusach Ashkenaz, even though it's a shtibel, there's a Rebbe there and everything. He said you could daven Nusach, because the whole Koilo is Ashkenaz. So the guy's daven Ashkenaz. And this guy almost jumped like over three benches because he didn't say Vayatzmach. He's screaming Vayatzmach! And he's like a literature guy. He's like, no, he doesn't Sfarad, and he went mad. And we still know the Rav said it's okay. No, no, this is a Sfarad place. What are you doing? He's screaming. Go back, go back. Like, you never see a guy have a cow like that before in your life. Okay. Never came back, that guy. Zogdi Gemara. So, why do we say Shtil Shemoneh Esrei? So the Chazan can get ready. According to you, that nobody's yoitza. If you know what's going on, you're not yoitza. So then why is it? Because once in a while, there's a guy that doesn't know how to read. In those days, it's very prevalent. Even 250 years ago, also people weren't learned that much. They didn't know how to read. Happens. Any baki. So the shliach tzibur is there. He's there to get whoever needs it. He'll be there to be mighty to you. So he's there to be mighty to you. If he can be mighty to you, he can be mighty even the people that know how to read. That's where Gamliel holds. Now I just want to stop here for a second because we have a few minutes until we go there. Important stuff. The Mishnah Berurah says. People wonder, what is this Chazor Shashat? We say the Shemoneh Esrei. Why do I need this guy to repeat everything? What's going on here? So, the Chavetz Chaim says that during Chazor Shashat, you should not learn. Shouldn't even learn. Why? He gives a reason. He says, because people are going to see you learning, they're going to think it's not important, and they're going to start talking in the middle of Chazor Shashat. You know how to talk about Chazor Shashat. So there's a guy in the neighborhood, a big Talmud Chacham, and he davens here every morning. And he argues on this. And he argues with me. I argue with him 100 times and I can't get anywhere with him. He has in his head, says, look, nobody's in Amaretz here. Nobody's going to talk in the middle of the Shema. I'm going to learn. Not only does he learn, he pulls out his Chumash, he does Shnai Mikra V'chatargim. I'm not kidding. So I saw Reb Chaim Ganevsky says today, whoever does Shnai Mikra V'chatargim in the middle of Chazor Shas, he's not Yoitza. It's a mitzvah Baba Aveira. He's not Yoitza. That's what he writes. And all the people that are learning, they're very, very problematic. I would love to learn. I would love to. So, but they say, here's what you can do. If you really want to learn, so it seems like most people hold, you can learn in your mind. You can think in learning, that's not a problem. So, but the importance of Chazor Shashat is tremendous. First of all, the Zohar talks about it. He says it's more important than what we daven, Shtol Shmon Esrei, whatever that means. It's a big thing. You see that if a person comes late to Shul, he should daven with the Chazan. When he davens with the Chazan word for word, he can say Kedusha. It's as if he davens b'tzibur. It's feel b'tzibur. So Chazor Shashat is very important. Another halacha. I brought this up, I think, in brachas. But what about people that wear Rabbeinu Tam? They should not take off their regular tefillin and switch into Rabbeinu Tam during Chazor Shashat. It's not appropriate. Chazor Shashat. And believe it or not, if you look in the Mechaber, I believe it's the Ramah because it's parentheses. He says you should stand during Chazor Shashat. That's the sheet of the Ramah. A lot of people don't know about it, or they're used to it. As soon as Kedush is over, plop down. It's an important thing. I'm just saying, think about it. It's not as light as people seem to make it out. It's not, oh, I said Shemoneh Esrei, what do I care? You do care. Not only that, if you don't have 10 people that answer Amen to the Chazan and not Mechavan, it's a bracha of Atala for the Chazan. So it's an important thing. It's not, think about it. Just think about it. Okay. Weiter. Omer Rabbi Rav Chana, Omer Rabbi Yochanan. Moidim Chachomim Lirim Gamliel. So here's what we have here. I'll just tell you the sugya real quickly. As any time we have a three-way machlokes, it's pretty much the same thing always, unless once in a while there's a little difference. You have the two extreme shitas, and then you have the middle one, the in-between. So Rabbi Gamaliel holds that a chazan can be mighty anybody all year round, even in the weekday, even Musaf, even Rosh Hashanah, no problem. Then you have Chachamim, who say a chazan can never be mighty anybody, even in Rosh Hashanah, never. And then you have Rabbi Meir, who says a chazan could do it in between, sometimes. When? On Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur, but no other day. Those are the three shitas we're about to learn now. Says the Gemara. So now the Gemara calls it Chachamim. And we're going to say that Chachamim is really Rabbi Meir. That's what we're going to do. The middle shita. That sometimes yes, sometimes not. Chachamim in fact hold never. Says the Gemara. Chachamim retracted and they said it's okay. A chazen can be mighty. What does mighty mean? They took it back. Once upon a time they argued. Now everybody agrees to Rabbi Gamliel. The Rav Omar Adayne Machloikis, not true. They never retracted it as a Machloikis. Shamo Rabbi Chia Berei the Rav Manachmeni Ozal Amor L'Shmaite Kamei the Rav Dimi Bar Chinino Omar Lei Hoch Yom Rav Adayne Machloikis. Yes, it's still Machloikis. We have the red and the blue. You see green, I did a Bedafka. Green means it's good. Chazen can do it for you. Red means no good. Can't do it for you. Blue is Paro. Today at least. Omalei ochi omar rav. Adani machlokes. Omalei. Omalei rav rav chanon. Nami ochi ko omar. Yeah. Rav rav chan agrees with you. Ki omar rabbi yochanan shmaitzo. If the galei rish lokish. Rish lokish argument with rabbi yochanan. Vom adani machlokes. Not true. Where was rav rav chan in the beginning? No. No. Okay. So rish lokish says no, it's no machlokes. Vom yom rabbi yochanan ochi. No machlokes. Vom rabbi chanon. Ma baya, Gary? Huh? Oh, yeah? Oy vey, somebody want to help him? A lot of Zoom bombers? Who's Mepharsim? Oh, they help you? You help them with the bombers? Okay. So if you say that Allah is like this, what does that mean? That they're arguing. Somebody's going to argue. How can you say, oh, that Allah is like Rabbi Gamliel? Meaning that there's somebody else in the picture. Otherwise, everybody holds like this. There's no, I don't have to paskin. Everybody holds the chazan could be mighty anybody. As we're going to see soon, it's unbelievable. There's a shita, Rabbi Gamliel, that a chazan can be mighty me in my bed. He's standing over here, dying Shemoneh Esrei, and I'm over there, he's mighty me. Because it's a community thing. He's doing it for everybody in the community. Top of Lamani Yomadal. What? We're not turning the page. I don't even have it here. You know what? Here's another thing. We have here with us Fishel. Fishel came up with a bunch of ideas for this year. And he's sponsoring the Gemara thing also. But his idea, right after the share, you can beat him up if you want. If you're annoyed at every time I turn the page and I say sponsored by, it's Fishel's idea. Fishel started, he gave the first $1,000 towards it, and since then, we raised tens of thousands of dollars with it. By the way, Fishel, the guy sponsoring is right behind you. So what should I say? Oh, but you're anonymous. I'm not going to tell anybody. Nobody look. Say it aloud. L'refuah shleima to? Shalat amachayar bat? Sarah. And that your sons are sitting next to you, nobody look? They should do well in Eretz Yisrael. Amen. It's hard to be anonymous in this year. It all goes. We're going to Daf Lamed Hey on the Aleph. Never happened before. Sponsored by Adam Bales in memory of his mother, Gail F. Rothner. We got Gidol Bad Pesach, the Chava Rivka. If you ever went in Yerushalayim, in Geula, the new, what is it called over there? Schneller, and Awesome in Bnei Brak. That's Ricky Rothner. He built those, and that was his wife, Aleha Shalom. Big Bal Tzedakah in Chicago. All right. So, Kisolig Rabbi Abba Miyami. Rabbi Yami came back from a trip. He was on a cruise somewhere, and he came back. B'chazar, that's what Rashi says. He's on a ship, and he came back. Persha explained. What I meant to say, what the Gemara meant to say, that there's an agreement, and there's a machlokes. There's an agreement over here. Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. But the rest of the year, they argue. So here's the machlokes. On a regular Wednesday afternoon, could a chazim be made to you? According to Rav Gamliel, yes. According to Chachamim, no. That's what he said. So, there is a machlokes here. But it's not true because he said that Halacha is like Rav Gamliel and Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur, meaning people are arguing with him in Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. You just said everybody agrees that Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur is different. Oh, so now the Gemara introduces someone else called Rav Meir, and that's the middle Shita. We have those who argue even on Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. They say Shliach Tzibur cannot be mighty anybody on Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. And then we have a middle Shita. Rosh Hashanah, you could be mighty, and during the year, not. And the Gemara is going to explain why. The Tanya brachos of Rosh Hashanah v'Shiyim HaKippurim Shliach Tzibur mighty Arabi Yidei Chivasan Divir Meir. Here, Remeir holds on Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur, special halacha that you don't have to know. You know why? Because the Gemara is going to say it's so complicated and they're long brachas, and people don't know them by heart, especially when they didn't have machzorim printed. The chazan can do it for you. But a weekday Shemoneh Esrei, you say it three times a day. There's no reason why you shouldn't know it bal peh, and chazan can't do it for you. Say, chachamim, no. If he could do it, you could do it, everybody's chayav. Maishna hani. Why is Yom Kippur Rosh Hashanah different? Yilei Rishon the Nefishi Kroi. If you're going to say, because there's a lot of psukim, Moram Chanan Elam Rav, Kim Shomar, Ubisirascha Kosov Leimar, Shuv Einoi Tsara. So let me just show you real quickly what it means. Ubisirascha Kosov Leimar. Es Musve Yom Azikorn as a Nasiv and Nakri Lufonecho, Bahava Kimitzer Sinecho, we're very familiar with this. Kim Moshe Kisafto Leim Sirasecho, Aidei, Moshe Avdecho. It's a little bit, there's a different nusach a little bit. The point is, if you say Ubisirascha Kosov Leimar, that's what it means. Then you are Yoytza. So you don't have to say the whole thing. What don't you have to say? So Rashi says over here, that's not talking about instead of the Malchuyos, Zechroinos, and Shoyfrois. It means instead of the Karban Musaf that we say. If instead of Musfe, Yoyim Hashem, the whole thing about Musaf, this the whole paragraph about, if you say the last line, you're Yoytza. But of course you have to say Malchuyos, Zechroinos, and Shoyfrois. So Gufa. Once you say that pasuk, that's it, you're done. So I would think that's only an individual. But a tibur not in our Rav Yishuv ben Levi, echad yachad echad tibur, kivin shomar b'siras kosov leimor, shov einoi tzarech. Even by the tibur. Omer Rav Elazar lo'ilom yazir adam tfilosoi, v'achkach yispalo. I'm going to go, somebody asked me if I could go almost to the last word, because he says many of his friends never made a siyum. They were watching the shir online, and they didn't get the last few words, and they didn't go to the siyum, and that was it. We're going to go all the way to the end, kimat, and anyway, it's not time. Hopefully they're going mishugah over there. What? Really? You know what we could do? We could just maybe tell Avigar Gir to come here and take things from people, and I don't know what we should do. He says they really need a half hour? Okay, we'll make a little kumzitz here. Fine. Omar Rebbe Lozor, Loilom Yazdor, the philosopher Agachis Palel. Omar Babbin, Mistab, and Milsa, the Rebbe Lozor, Bibrochish, Rosh Hashanah, Vashim. Okay. So you hear what it says over here? Loilom Yazdir Adam Tfilosoi Vakachis Palo. A person must organizes tefillah, know what he's saying, know what he's doing, then he goes and davens. What about in our days? Our days is a little different. Because our days, we have a siddur. So you don't really need that lesader. We have a siddur, which is mesader for us. That makes sense. Prokim means Yom Tovim. Okay, not everybody knows Yom Tov davening. Not everybody knows Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. Most people don't know. Avod Kol Hashanah Loi, Kol Hashanah all year round. What you need help in Shmoneh Esrei? You just go in and you daven. Eini, but Rav Yehuda misadet Loi Simatzle. What about Rav Yehuda? He used to organize his tefillah. So you see, Rav Yehuda didn't know by heart. Shani Rav Yehuda, Kivin Demitlasin Yoyim Demitlasin Yoyim Havim Matzli Kiprokim Dami. You know what the Gemara says there? Unbelievable. Rav Yehuda only davened once every 30 days. That's it. Why? Because Rav Yehuda used to chazer his Gemara. He used to do mizumanim. He was busy chazering the entire Torah. Kol HaTorah Kula. He didn't have time for davening. We know the Reb Shimon Bar Yochai, the Chaverov, the Potter from Tefillah. If it's Torah Sungna, so you literally live Torah, you don't daven. Kriya Shema? Of course. What do you mean? That's where it comes from, this whole thing. But we don't really have people like that. But Kriya Shema, you have to say every day. Now, what about a lulav, tefillin, those kind of things? If you're learning all day, do you have to do? Yes. But tefillah is different. Tefillah is that Kosh Baruch Hu should have compassion, rachmanas. If you're learning, you don't have to daven at all. So you daven once every 30 days. So once every 30 days, he's like somebody that could get mixed up because he's not used to it. So Mela, he had to be Mesader as Tefillah. Comes out an amazing thing. Today, we did Kiddush Levana. And there was a minion outside. We were davening. There's like 40, 50 people. And after davening, they're going to the moon. I said, Rabbi Yisai, while you're looking for the moon, I didn't want to disturb people. I said, I just learned an amazing halacha, literally an hour before Kiddush Levana. I learned an amazing halacha. The Machzor Shekel says, and the Mishnah Berurah brings him down, since we say Kiddush Levana only every 30 days, so you mechuyev to look in a siddur when you say Kiddush Levana. That's what the Gemara says here. Rav Yehuda, we're not better than Rav Yehuda. What? You think you knew Shmoneh Esrei better than Rav Yehuda knows it? But since he said it every 30 days, he had to be Mesader Tefillah, he's mechuyev to be Mesader Tefillah. So any tefillah that comes around once every 30 days, like Hallel, so there's a need that in Rishayim is Hallel considered because maybe it's every 29 days. But in Cheshvan, it's 31 days, then you'd be chayev. But it's a nice halacha, no? Kiddush Levana must be done within a siddur, according to the Machzor Shekel, since he's my great-grandfather, I have to do it. You guys don't. Okay, weiter. Omer Avacha, Bravira, Omer Ibshim Chasido. Poitoyurim Gamliel, Afilu Am Shivasadois. You hear this? That's an amazing halacha. Rabbi Gamliel, who holds that a chazan can be moitzi everybody all year round, even the guys that are 20 minutes away in the field. Why? Because he's a chazan, he does it for the whole city, and these guys have a problem getting back. So it comes out that if a chazan can be moitzi somebody in the field, he certainly can be moitzi somebody that's in the shul that doesn't feel like davening. Says Gemara, no. Adarabba. Hani anisei, hani lo anisei. So you think about it. Today we have some farmers, but very, very few. In those days, imagine working in the heat, in the sun, in the rain. That's how they made parnasa. They had to go out there, and we see from all these gemaras, they used to come minutes before Shabbos. Last minute, they didn't have time to for anything. They worked like mamish, like ferrets back then. Most of us sit by a desk, this, that. Some of us are plumbers. Superior plumbing in Muncie. No, but I'm saying that even the plumber guy, he has a nice air conditioned truck, he has the right tools, he's working indoors, he's not working out in the field, mamish, with the sun burning you. They didn't even have hats those days, they didn't have umbrellas, you know, it's a tough thing. So these guys are anusim. For him to make it all the way back from the field, who knows where the field was, to come back to Shul, to Daven Shmoneh Esrei, it's impossible. Anos, the chazan can be mighty him. They didn't even have time to. You see the whole Gemara and Brachas, they were on the tree and they could he bench. It's also the bench. Could say a few things. There's no mincha, there's no shachars, there's nothing. The chazan is mighty him everything. At least one benefit, you look at it. Chas v'shalom. L'toni ava b'rei de Rabbi Yomin bar Chiyo am shachori koyanim enom b'chlal bracha. What? Okay, now it's Avi's turn to make sure that we delay the thing. Get over here. I don't care what you said. Whatever. We'll just barge in there without sponge or with food. Who cares? I'm Shachori Kayhanim, and then Menachem Ateh told me, why are you doing it so late? And I told him, it's what's the Shabbos? Who knows what's going to happen? I'm Shachori Kayhanim, Einam Bechlal Bracha. So, in our stroll, we're very familiar. You have the Kayhanim standing over here, right? Up in front, you have a Rechava. If you're standing right behind the Kayhanim, you're not Yoytze. And there's guys, I had the privilege of davening by Prushim over there. So the Yushalmis, they run to the Kayan. Like each one, they're fighting, they're getting from position. They have to be like 100% in front of him, because if it's a little bit to the side, they're not Yoytze that much. So, but it says over here, but if you're behind, not. So if you're behind, or if you're in a field, of course you're not Yoytze. Elok Yasa Ravan Omer Rabbi Yaakov Baridi Omer Rabbi Shimon Chasido Loi Potar Ring Amliel Elo Am Shebasadois. My time? It's scary. I don't want to finish it here. Mishum Da'anise B'melacha. Now, if you're watching online, just say the next three words. I'm not going to say them. We'll say it in an hour from now. Loi Potar Ring Amliel Elo Am Shebasadois Mishum Da'anise B'melacha. Because they have an oinus. They can't get there. But other people. Now, what are we going to do, Rabbi Isai? Let's sing a little bit. El Yeshua Si. Are you on? You able to hear
me,
Gary?
You can hear me?
Okay.
So we learned the Mishnah Shalish al Shalish Shalish. So Rashi holds that Shalish al Shalish Shalish means that from Malchus, Zechonis, and Shoifris, you blow a Tkia, a Trua, and a Tkia. Shitas Rashi is that the Trua is three small sounds, Shkailas Kol Shehu, which for explanation purposes, we're going to call Trumitin. It sounds like this. That's it. According to Rashi, your full set of Tkia, Trua Tkia, is going to sound like this. Zel, that's your entire set according to Rashi. Taisvis holds, the Riva and the Rivam hold, that no, a Yavava is three small sounds, or nine Trumitin, which is the Trua more familiar with. That's your nine Kailas. So now, when we get to the Gemara, we have your Shvarim Trua. So, we're used to the Shvarim. So, according to Rashi, if your Trua is only three sounds, and your Tkia has to be the length of your Trua, you can't have a very long Shvarim. So the Ritva says it's Kishtayim. So your Shvarim Trua is going to sound like this. It's drop longer than your Trua, but just shorter than your Tkia. According to Taisvis, it's as long as it's less than nine Trumitin, it's fine. So your Shvarim Trua is going to sound like this. That's your Shvarim Trua. Now, as we learned in the Gemara, that you don't do in the opposite order because people don't cry like that. So now we have the Shita of the Ramban. The Ramban in Drasha Trashana brings Rabbeinu Tam, whether they do it in Neshima Achas or Shtei Neshimas. So, Neshima Achas is going to sound like this. No breath in between. Most Paiskim hold in Rabbeinu Tam. When you do Shtei Neshimas, you actually take a breath in between. So, we're going to do it like this. Quick intake of air in between. And according to most Paiskim, that is how you do Shtei Neshimas according to Rabbeinu Tam. So now, some of you might be coming from a little bit more Litvisha backgrounds or in the yeshivas, and you have the wavy, or you have the ones that go up and down. So that again also is that the Ramban holds that it has to be, that the shever has to sound like a kol shover, a broken sound. So it can't be a flat monotone sound. It has to be changing in sound. So there are different minhagim that have developed what they sound like. So let's give some examples. That's one. That's another one. Then you have some that go like this, where it goes up and down. So the point of going up and down is that you guarantee that your shever is long enough and you can't cut it short. Because since you're going up and down, it guarantees it's going to be three and you can't cut it short. So Rabbeinu Tam holds that, nope, it's monotone. So it's going to be your shvarim trua. Now, a lot of the Rishonim, as brought down in the tour, hold that the shever, and the trua at least, is not nine separate sounds or three separate sounds. It's one long wavy sound, which a lot of people might be familiar with as the Teimana Shetkias. It's just going up and down, one long up and down sound. So that's the true. That's going to be your trua. That shita of Sadi Goyin, the Rambam, the Pashtus, and the Rambam, the Pashtus, and it's brought down by the Bala, is the Bala Iter in the tour. So the length of the tkia has to be the length of the shvarim trua. Some rishayim hold that it has to be both book and tkias, the length of them together. So according to some rishayim, like the Rambam, as long as, let's say, for argument's sake, let's say that your shvarim trua takes you 4 seconds, as long as each tkia is longer than 2 seconds, or yaitse. However, the we paskin that it's going to be longer than the whole amount. So the way we're used to blowing, that the whole amount in the Shema Achas, the entire set is going to sound like this. That's your entire set. The keys were long on both ends. Your Shvarim Trua, that's what it is. So now I know, especially since it's a leap year, we have an extra month to it. But now that we've gone through the sugis and Bez Hashem, we get to Rosh Hashanah, Abal, and Lutayva, since we've gone through the sugis, we'll now know exactly what the Baal Tekeah is doing when he does it.
I think you should do it again. I think you should do it again, no? Okay, fine.
Oh, one last thing.
At least 100 toilets.
One last thing. There's a shita that's usually known as the Chazon Ish, and it's also the Avnei Nezer and Chuvas, that says that Neshima Achas is that it has to be one continuous sound. So it sounds like this. It goes straight into the trua because it has to be most of the Tamidi Chazon Ish and the Chazon Ish is that you can't be able to tell the difference where the shever ends and where the trua begins. So again, it sounds like this. That there's very, it's almost impossible to tell exactly where it is. So, one quick chazara. Rashi. Taisis. Timani. Did I miss anything?
Chazon Ish.